Thank you, Chairman. I am Jeon Ban from Sejong General Hospital. I am pediatric cardiologist and electrophysiologist. It's my great honor to present here today. My topic is about treatment of arrhythmia in adult congenital heart disease. Advanced management and surgical outcome allow the survival and increased risk of arrhythmia in adult congenital heart disease. The arrhythmia risk is dependent on underlying heart anatomy, prior surgical history, and hemodynamic status. This table shows arrhythmia prevalence in adult congenital heart disease. All spectrum of arrhythmia can be encountered in adult congenital heart disease. Darker blue is indicate higher risk of arrhythmic event. The common tachyarrhythmia are supraventricular tachycardia, especially intra-atrial renal tachycardia, IART. These are usually treated cath ablation. Longer life expectancy increases the prevalence of AP. Medical and cath ablation are the treatment strategy. Ventricular tachycardia management is focused on prevention of sudden cardiac death. So ICD implantation and adjuvant cath ablation is indicated in selected patients. Bradycardia is usually managed by cardiac pacing therapy. First issue is atrial tachyarrhythmia. Intra-atrial reentrant tachycardia formed macro-reentrant loop like this. IART is most common tachyarrhythmia in post-operative congenital heart disease, from ASD to more complex diseases such as Mustard and Sanding Baffling DTJ, and functional single ventricle with AP Fontan. This case is example for IART. 32 years old male underwent Mustard operation at the age of 22 years. Surface ECG shows atrial flutter. Cardiac CT shows the systemic venous atrium. 3D activation map during tachycardia shows figure of 8, a white arrow. The isthmus at the posterior suture line at the inferior baffle. This is a fluoroscopic image of ablation site. This is our case in repaired TOF. 47 years male patient experienced palpitation after percutaneous pulmonary valve implantation. Several times cardioversion was performed during tachycardia because of hemodynamic compromised state. During procedure, coronary sinus venography shows left SVC with huge dilated coronary sinus. During EP study, two different SVT was induced. 3D mapping system shows macro-reentrant count clockwise and clockwise atrial flutter was induced like this. CTI ablation with bidirectional block was achieved. This figure shows the outcome of IART in adult congenital heart disease. A total of 193 IART ablation was analyzed. Red bar is a total patient group. Yellow is AST, blue is TOF, green is Mustard repair, purple is Fontan group. Acute procedural success is 63% in total group. IART recurrence was 48% 4 years after successful ablation. Longer life expectancy increased risk of atrial fibrillation in adult congenital heart disease. The prevalence is 31%. The mechanism of APV is related to chronic hemodynamic stress and remodeling of atrium. As shown in figure, patients with congenital heart disease develop APV at a young age compared to normal population. Previously, multicenter study assessed the type and pattern of atrial tachyarrhythmia in adult congenital heart disease. A total of 482 patients were enrolled in this study. The most common tachyarrhythmia was IART, about 60%, and IART increased with the disease complexity. In addition, IART was predominant arrhythmia in younger age, account for 75%. By contrast, AP increased with age, and the most common tachyarrhythmia in those older 50 years of age. Pharmacologic management AP in congenital heart disease include acute termination, rate and rhythm control, and prevention of thromboembolic complication. Light table shows the classification of disease complexity of congenital disease. Regarding acute management of APV in congenital disease, cardioversion can be performed in urgent case. If AP persists more than 48 hours, at least 3 weeks anticoagulation and/or transesophageal echo is necessary before cardioversion. As medical conversion of APV in congenital disease, recently intravenous Ebutilide was used for conversion of atrial tachyarrhythmia. However, this drug is not introduced in Korea. To rate control of APV, beta blocker is recommended in congenital disease. In addition, calcium channel blocker can be also used, but it has not insufficient evidence. But digoxin is not recommended in congenital disease. This algorithm shows the rhythm control. According to the disease complexity, the use of antiarrhythmic drugs are different. In simple and moderate congenital disease, class 1C and class 3 drug can be used. In complex type, class 3 is recommended. Amiodarone is the most effective antiarrhythmic drug for APV in the setting of heart failure and congenital disease. However, long-term treatment is limited in young adults because of drug toxicity, especially women, patients with unimpaired cyanotic lesion, and bone time patients. Pharmacologic therapy should consider sinus node dysfunction, impaired AV nodal function, systemic or pulmonic ventricular dysfunction, associated therapy, childbearing potential, and acquired comorbidity. Regarding thromboprophylaxis, patients with moderate to severe congenital heart disease, the presence of a prosthetic valve should receive long-term anticoagulation with vitamin K antagonist. Although CHA2DS2 score system has not been fully validated for congenital heart disease, if the score is more than 2, anticoagulation is recommended. As non-pharmacologic therapy, first choice is CASTA ablation. CASTA ablation of APV is class 2A indication in symptomatic drug refractory APV in congenital heart disease. 3D mapping system is essential and irrigated ablation CASTA can be useful. This example of APV ablation in congenital heart disease, 63 years old woman with surgically repaired ASD had persistent APV. Popular B in isolation was shown in LA high density mapping. In RA mapping, asterisks are interatrial patch. The arrow indicate atrial suture line. Atrial scarring leading to arrhythmogenic foci may develop after surgical repair. Recently, the clinical outcome of CASTA ablation of APV in adult congenital heart disease was demonstrated. Among 240 patients, 53% had persistent APV, mean age was 55 years. Congenital heart disease complexity was categorized as simple and intermediate and severe. Simple was 60%, intermediate about 30%, and severe was 10%. Blue bar is partial success, yellow bar is complete success. 1 year complete and partial success rate was 45% and 20%. There was no significant difference between complex success between complexity group. Next is ventricular tachyarrhythmia. Sustained VT can develop in adult congenital heart disease and may result in sudden cardiac death. It is associated with 20% of mortality of adult congenital heart disease in TOF, Epstein anomaly, left side obstructive disease. In repaired TOF, sustained monomorphic VT is predominant, and the mechanism is macro reentry. This figure shows the poor anatomic isthmus of VT in repaired TOF. Isthmus 1 and 2 is between RV incision and tricuspid valve and pulmonic valve. Isthmus 3 and 4 between the VS patch and pulmonic valve and tricuspid valve. Among them, isthmus 1 and 3 are most common. As the mechanism of VT, the initial substrate is consequence of congenital anomaly and surgical repair. Long-standing hemodynamic insert leads to progressive fibrosis and slow conduction, allowing the generation of sustained VT like this. This is the example of slow conduction anatomic isthmus in repaired TOF. Calto voltage map and activation map was shown. This is pulmonary valve and tricuspid valve. Gray color is VS patch scar region. Here is the anatomic isthmus region. This algorithm shows management of ventricular arrhythmia in adult congenital heart disease. If clinical presentation is sustained monomorphic VT or cardiac arrest, ICD implantation is indication. If patient experiences syncope and sustained palpitation, EP study is recommended. If patient has PVC or non-sustained VT with minor symptom, beta blocker can be considered. This table shows the clinical factor to consider EP study. If patient has multiple risks such as following, beta blocker or EP study is considered. ICD therapy is class 1 indication in intracardiac arrest and sustained VT and LV ejection fraction less than 35% and ear functional class 2 or 3. In repaired TOF, multiple risk factor for sudden cardiac death are class 2A indication of ICD implantation. The benefit of ICD therapy is primary prevention for single or systemic RV is less well established. Catheter ablation is adjunctive therapy to ICD in recurrent monomorphic VT, VT storm, and multiple ICD shock. It is class 1 indication. However, recently, treatment strategy in repaired TOF is a little bit changed. According to AHA statement, EPS and substrate mapping is recommended as the first step treatment in hemodynamic unstable and stable VT. In case of hemodynamic unstable VT, ICD is essential therapy, although ablation was performed. If patient has a hemodynamic stable VT, ICD can be implanted when it is indicated. Let's move to bradyarrhythmia. Sinus node dysfunction and AV block may occur either spontaneously and post-operative iatrogenic sequelae. Indication for permanent pacing are symptomatic sinus node dysfunction, symptomatic bradycardia, congenital or post-operative complete AV block. When we plan cardiac pacing in adult congenital heart disease, there are several peri-implant considerations. Intracardiac anatomy, venous access, sinus and AV node function, evaluation, and optimal lead implantation site. Technically, standard transvenous system may not be feasible due to venous anatomy in adult congenital disease, so epicardial implantation is preferred in certain circumstances. Leadless pacemaker has emerged as an option to avoid complication. For patients with challenging vascular access, tricuspid valve disease, intracardiac shunt, and the risk of device infection, leadless pacemaker may be considered. However, some potential limitations such as larger sized sheaths and lack of atrial sensing and pacing. This is example for leadless pacemaker in repaired TOF. Pre-implantation map was done in multiple sites in RV. Leadless pacemaker is implanted guided by local pacing parameter like this. Pacing-induced cardiomyopathy developed frequently in adult congenital disease, wide QRS duration and ventricular dysfunction at baseline, higher pacing burden are risk factor. CRT has been shown to promote reverse ventricle remodeling. Class 1 indication of CRT is like this. Adult with congenital heart disease, systemic LV ejection pressure less than 35% and sinus rhythm with wide QRS complex more than 150 milliseconds with complete LVVV morphology and ear functional class 2 to 4. CRT in adult congenital heart disease has been evaluated in the type of failure of systemic LV, systemic RV, and functional single ventricle. This algorithm shows the CRT in various states such as systemic LV, systemic RV, and single ventricle failure. Technically, hybrid approach should be considered in atrial switch in DTGA, with the transvenous lead in supramonic LV and epicardial pacing of the systemic RV. This case is a physiologic repair of CCTGA after CRT, QRS duration was much narrower and echo strain was much better synchronous. This study shows the dyssynchrony type and ideal pacing lead position. Short axis dyssynchrony, long axis dyssynchrony, and interventricular dyssynchrony. Short axis dyssynchrony is single ventricle with biventricle here. Long axis dyssynchrony of RV in systemic RV. Interventricular dyssynchrony biventricle with systemic RV. Pink dot indicate recommended pacing lead position. Conduction system pacing has been shown cardiac resynchronization, physiologic His bundle pacing or left bundle branch pacing has been proven better outcome in non-congenital heart disease patient. Although the potential limitation of surgical scarring near the conduction system, the anatomic variation in congenital heart disease, conduction system pacing has resulted in greater QRS narrowing and improvement of LV ejection fraction. This recent study shows the conduction system pacing in CCTGA in adult congenital disease. Total 15 patients with complete AV block in CCTGA were enrolled. Mean age was 23 years. 13 patients were successful. During follow-up, pacing threshold was maintained and functional class was improved in 5 patients. This slide shows the patient characteristic. Mild RV dysfunction was 60%. Using 3D mapping system, his Purkinje network was detected like this. And conduction system pacing was performed under ICE guidance. As you can see, QRS duration was narrow post-procedure. In summary, management of arrhythmia should be considered according to the underlying anatomy, prior surgical history, mechanism of arrhythmia, and hemodynamics. Atrial tachyarrhythmia, IART, and AP are the most common cardiac arrhythmia in adult congenital heart disease. The management of ventricular tachyarrhythmia is focused on risk stratification for the prevention of sudden cardiac death. CRT and conduction system pacing are the important adjuvant therapy for selected adult congenital heart disease with heart failure. Thank you for your attention.